All right, first and foremost, I want to start off by saying, Barakat Hawa, Barakat Hawa Shai. Barakat Hawa, Barakat Hawa Shai. Barakat Hawa, Barakat Hawa Shai. Call Allah Yahawa, Bahashem Yahawa Shai, Bahashem Rakak Wadash. Double honors to the apostles of GMS who rule well and who taught me this truth. And a shalom to you, Sincere Akiyam, out there listening, learning, and pushing this truth. And with that being said, I'm going to jump straight into this video. As usual, I'm going to go into Rakak Wadash, and Lord's willing, it'll be edifying. All right, and I'm going to be real quick. I just got a couple videos that I'm going to show, pretty much. All right, pretty much an update on the coronavirus. All right, I'm going to play a video on two videos on that, pretty much. Oslakia, today's date is January 27th, 2020, the year of prophecy, for the record. All right, so I'm going to play two videos on the coronavirus, all right? And also, as of today, January 27th, 2020, the year of prophecy, which we already know, we heard about the Kobe thing. We already know about Kobe. That's pretty much old news at this point now, right? Because, you know, prophecies are popping off. It's constantly, every day, something's happening, man. You can't even keep up at this point, all right? So from today, January 27th, 2020, off of Al Jazeera, there was a plane crash in Afghanistan. I'm going to play that video. And they actually have footage of the actual the plane that went down in Afghanistan. And apparently on RT, I'm going to play this video also. It says a plane carrying high-ranking U.S. officers downed by Taliban in Afghanistan. And we know today also, I guess yesterday or whatever, last night, yesterday sometime, they actually, I think 37 troops were injured or killed or something like that in Iraq. I guess they bombed the embassy in Iraq again also. So things are popping off, man. All right. Things are popping off, man. We are in the year of prophecy, as Elder Apostle Tahor coined it, man. We are truly in the year of prophecy. And the prophecies are the year is starting off with a bang. The decade is starting off with a bang, all right? So anyway, I'm gonna hit two scriptures and hit the videos, and we're out of here. I'm not going to be long-winded, you know, because like I said, we already know what time it is, man. We know what time it is, all right? The word has already gone out, all right? You know exactly what our message is, what our doctrine is, okay? Repent, the kingdom of heaven is at hand, okay? You know everything. That's why you're watching, all right? You have no need for me to write unto you. You know within yourself what time it is, all right? Repent, the kingdom of heaven is at hand. The doors of mercy are closing drastically, all right? Jacob's trouble is about to commence, all right? We're in them times. We're in the last days, all right? So anyway, Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 7, it says, "Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it." Yeah, the times that we're about to enter into, per Daniel chapter 12, it says it's going to be a time as never before, man. All right? All right? Famine, pestilence, okay? Civil unrest, all right? Martial law, wars and rumors of wars, all right? A time like never before, okay? It says, "Alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it." It is even the time of Jacob's trouble. And that's what time we're in, man. We're in the time of Jacob's trouble. We're at the doorsteps, okay? It hasn't fully commenced yet, but it's about to, okay? It says, but he shall be saved out of it. Who's going to be saved out of it? Jacob, Yasharala. But at this point in juncture, only the elect, okay? The elect of Israel. As it is written, 2/3 are going to perish, okay? So, hey, straight to the point right here, you know? 2 Ezra 9:1 again. "He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs past, which I have told thee before, then shall thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made." And that's what times are in, man. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is about to visit this place, all right? And he's going to start at the house of Israel, man, all right? All right? But we in them times. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is visiting this place, all right? All right? Salakia. So let me play these videos and then we're out of here, all right? I'm going to play these first, okay? I'm going to play the actual footage off of RT, because this is big news, man. Like I said, off of RT, January 27th, 2020, the year of prophecy, it says, "Plane carrying high-ranking U.S. officers downed by Taliban in Afghanistan, okay? So let me play this, and I'll play the other video, and we're out of here. Remember yesterday, allegedly, well, not allegedly, we know for a fact, Kobe Bean Bryant and his daughter, you know, they went down in a plane crash with nine others. I guess it was nine people in total, right? That was yesterday. But, hey, the prophecies are moving, man. Right? Yahabah Shemi Hawashai is not a respecter of persons, man. We in them times, all right? Things are going to start to speed up, all right? As it is written, Yahweh Hawashai said he was going to shorten the days for the elect's sake. And that's what he's doing. He's shortening the days. He's speeding up. He's speeding up these prophecies. All right. And we know what that's going to lead, what, Esau, Edom to come down with great wrath, because he knows he has but a short time. All right. So anyway, this is off of Al Jazeera. This is the same plane crash, right, that they're reporting on. It says, January 27th, 2020, the year of prophecy. It says, plane crashes in Afghanistan's Ghazni Province. Okay? Real short video. You know.
Breaking news from Afghanistan. A passenger plane reportedly crashed near the center of the Deir Yak district in the eastern province of Ghazni. All right, let's go live to the Afghan capital, Kabul. We'll speak to our correspondent, Zain Bazravi. What more do we know, Zain?
Well, Martin, since we last spoke, there have been some serious developments in this case. It turns out...
You see, we're scrolling across the ticker. That's what I was reporting on. It says, three rockets land in U.S. Embassy compound in Iraq. And one of the reports, I said, it was like 30-something people. I don't know. One report said 30-something U.S. soldiers killed. And another one said injured. So I'm not sure exactly what happened. I got to do further research on this particular thing in Iraq right quick. All right. You know, but we in them times, man. Things are speeding up. All right. You know, let's not forget Yahweh Shemi Hawashai is still gathering the armies down in the Valley of Yahweh Shepat. All right. Don't forget the third woe is coming quickly, man. All right. A lot of things are going to start to take place, man. Mass death. Okay. Not to mention the famine of the word, all right? The demonization of the men of the Lord. All these things must needs come to pass, and we're in them times, all right? The doors of mercy are drastically closing. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Repent. The kingdom of heaven is at hand, okay?
Breaking news from Afghanistan, a passenger plane reportedly crashed near the center of the Deir Yak district in the eastern province of Ghazni. All right, let's go live to the Afghan capital, Kabul. We'll speak to our correspondent, Zain Bazravi. What more do we know, Zain?
Well, Martin, since we last spoke, there have been some serious developments in this case. It turns out that the spokesman for the governor of Ghazni province, Arif Nuri, the spokesman, has been speaking from that province and has said that according to his people on the ground, this is not an Afghan aircraft. So that would suggest that it is not an Ariana Airlines aircraft.
Yeah, like I said, this, according to RT, they're saying it was a U.S. plane, all right? Like I said, it's a plane carrying high-ranking U.S. officers down. So like I said... We're in the time of war, man, okay?
As previously was...
And people already forgot about the assassination of that damn general over there in Iran, okay? Don't forget, Esau likes to do bread and circus distractions, okay? You know, I'm not saying... We all know that Kobe's death was sanctioned by Yahweh Shemi Hawashai, but, you know, it could still have been Esau. Could have took him out of here, you know? We're not ignorant of Satan's devices, but nonetheless... It's still Yahweh Shemi Hawashai that sanctioned it, that gave the okay. You know, the issues of death belongeth unto Yahweh, okay? So it is what it is, but we're not ignorant, man. There's a lot of things are popping off left and right, you know. You know, don't get caught up in this distractions, all right? This bread and circus.
suggests that it is not an Ariana Airlines aircraft, as previously was suspected by many people. Now, we were hearing that the government was deploying troops to the area, and we know that Afghan security forces are at the scene, and reports we're hearing from those eyewitnesses is that all passengers on board are deceased, there are no survivors, and...
See, it's going to be mass death out here. It says the slain of the Lord shall be many, man. Was the Isaiah 66, I believe? If I'm not mistaken, could be mistaken. But yeah, it said the slain of the Lord shall be many, man. He's going to slay utterly old and young. And it's going to be mass death out here. This is only the beginning, man. Okay? More celebrities, more stars are going to fall from heaven if you can receive it. All right? More of your idols are going to die. All right? Mass death. Loved ones. Okay? People close to you are going to die, all right? From the race wars, from the famine, martial law, from the pestilences, all right? It's going to be all hell out here, man, okay? I'm going to end this here. You can get the idea, all right? So I'm going to play this one here. This is real quick, and then I'll play this. This is what I really wanted to play from January 25th, 2020. It says Wuhan nurse, right? That's the heart of where that coronavirus broke out at. It's the heart. It's the center. It says, Wuhan nurse tells the truth about coronavirus. This is really what I wanted to play. I'm going to end to close it out with that. But let me hit another one again, man, because we're in them times, man. Real quick. It says, alas, for that day is great, so that none is like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble, but he shall be saved out of it. All right? So, hey, Lord's willing, we be those men and those women. You know, we keep enduring. You know, keep being faithful, you know, we'll be delivered. We'll have that hedge around us, that tawa, be exempt from judgment, all right? Protected from that hour of temptation, you know? That's about to try this whole world, man. You know, when Esau Edom, the red Hebrew Edomite, makes that RFID chip mandatory, man. You know, problem, reaction, solution, as the brother Isaiah brought out. You know, order out of chaos, all right? The solution to everything, to all the calamities that's befallen this place, is going to be that RFID microchip, which is the mark of the beast. And if you take that chip, you will be destroyed. Thus saith Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, okay? There's no repentance from taking that chip, man, all right? That mark, that beast, that karagma, all right? All right, so anyway, you've been warned, man. Repent.
The streets in the capital, Beijing, are almost empty, and they'll most likely stay that way until next Monday, now that the Lunar New Year holiday has been extended to help curb the spread of the coronavirus. More countries and territories have increased restrictions on people from Hubei province, or even banned their entry in some cases, as the Chinese government continues with its plan on containing and treating those who have the virus.
I have to keep wearing the same mask. If I throw this away, I have no mask then.
And that's not no little 3M. All right, that's a major company. That ain't no lightweight mask, man. That ain't no little dollar mask, okay? And this still can't protect you because they're saying that your eyes got to be covered, all right? It's an airborne virus, man, okay? And the nurse is going to explain how deadly it is. It's highly deadly, highly contagious, all right? You know, one person can infect around like 14 people, man, at a time, okay? Highly contagious, all right? And it's mutating. It's getting stronger, okay? And it's spread already. It's already, they can't contain it, man. It's already in America. Last night, it was like 5 confirmed cases in the United States, man. It's hit Australia, France, okay? All right? So we're in some serious times, man. We're in them times. And it's only going to get worse, man. More pestilences, all right? All right? Much more. This is just the beginning. You ain't seen nothing yet.
I'm asking the government to sell more masks.
I found out that
this little cheap ass mask that ain't gonna do nothing to you. You through. He's through. You know, his eyes aren't protected. He's through, man. Okay, that ain't gonna protect you. All right. And as they're saying, it's attacking the old and the young people with the weak immune systems. All right. But they're fearful that it'll mutate. Okay. And remember, this coronavirus. It came from what? A so-called snake that jumped to the virus jumped from a snake to a bat to people. So it has snake DNA in it. It has bat DNA and people DNA. All right. So this virus is highly resilient, man. Okay. You see? We in them times, man. He said he was going to smite Egypt with the plagues as before, and with plagues not written in the book thereof, all right? So we in them times.
Hard to buy food and vegetables now. I hope the situation can get better.
As the Chinese government continues with its plan on containing and treating those who have the virus.
I have to keep wearing the same mask. If I throw this away, I have no mask then. I'm asking the government to sell more masks.
I found out that everything is sold out. Hard to buy food and vegetables now. I hope the situation...
They're saying, I was watching another video, they're saying that there's already mass panic out there. Basically, it's a famine out there already. A man-made famine because of the fear and them being locked in their houses. Everyone hit the grocery stores and bought up all the goods. So all the masks are sold out on Amazon. All the masks are sold out. A lot of food is gone off the shelves, all right? It's panic out there. Pandemonium, all right? You see, but it's only the beginning. It's going to spread. It's going to spread, man, all right? If not this disease, another pestilence. Because it's written. It must needs come to pass, man. And it's going to hit Babylon the Great sooner than you believe, man. All right? It's coming to a city and a town nearer than you believe, man. Jacob's trouble. All right? Our redemption is nearer than you believe, man. All right?
Can get better after the Chinese New Year holiday.
China's second most powerful government official, Premier Li Keqiang, has been put in charge of the coronavirus situation. He traveled down to Wuhan and visited the construction site of a hospital that's being purpose-built for the virus.
And they're building two hospitals. That's incorrect, because they're building two hospitals now. At first they said one, but they're building two hospitals within a week to deal with this virus. That show you how serious it is. That show you how serious and how deadly it is. They're building two brand new hospitals in Wuhan just to deal with the outbreak, man. Okay, all right. And many people have already came out and said, you know, on Twitter and social media, they've been showing people. Well, before prior to the quarantine, they were showing people dropping dead in the streets, man. That's how deadly it is. All right, and a lot of people were out and about socializing. Because I guess they said they knew about it since roughly November or December, but they didn't tell the people. And the people were out and about, as usual, socializing, eating, conversing with each other, spreading the virus, man, showing no symptoms. That you can have the coronavirus, they say, for up to 10 days without showing any symptoms. But within them 10 days that you have the virus, you're highly contagious, man, and you're just spreading it. So a lot of these people have already left the country of China, left Wuhan, went abroad, went to the Americas, Australia, Europe, okay, with this virus on them, man, on this plane, on a small plane, you know, spreading that virus, man, that's highly contagious, as you're going to see, all right? So we are serious, man. We're in serious times, man, all right? Serious, deadly serious, man, life and death, all right?
We should build this
song. How about Shemir Hawashai, like I said, is visiting the world which he made, man. He's beginning to visit. He's beginning to visit the world which he made.
As soon as possible. We set the date as February 2nd.
Anyway, let's play this. This is what I really wanted you, because I don't want to make this video too long. You can always look these videos up. I've showed you already. You can do your own diligence. You know, it says let each man be fully persuaded in their own mind. All right. So this is from a Lyndon Lee. I guess he re-uploaded this video here. And it's from January 25th, 2020, like I said, all right? It says, Wuhan nurse tells the truth about coronavirus. And I'm going to just play this one out. I'm not going to probably interject and shut it down on this, all right? Lord's willing, this video was edifying, all right? Like I always say, we almost out of here, right? Shalom. Wa abad babal. Keep pushing, repent, you know, seek the Lord while he may be found, all right?
我是金慧，各位长辈们，我是景慧，我目前还在武汉防控这个疫区，我向大家汇报一下目前我们整个湖北甚至全国的疫情情况。现在已经有9万多人次，这个病毒的传染几率是多少呢？就是一个人。 传染之后， 或者说进行优秀的资料的话，它会传染给他身边的14个人，那么这个基数就很大了。现在正值春节假期之际，天南地北的亲戚朋友、子女都往家里赶，都是为了合家团圆，在一起吃一顿团年饭。 现在情况特殊，我希望大家不要出门，不要聚会，不要聚餐，春节年年有。So pretty much
the mirth in China's gone out of the land right there. The mirth in China's gone, man. He said you can't go out, you can't eat, you can't celebrate. Okay, you're right. The mirth of that land is gone out. And the mirth of Babylon the Great, this land is going to go out, all right? All right, you people are ignorant, willfully ignorant, you know, in la-la land, you know. But, hey, that day is coming, man. It's going to catch you people off guard, man, as a thief in the night. You're going to catch, Yahweh Shemayah Shai going to catch you with your pants down, man. You're going to wish you took heed, man.
我现在向大家介绍一下我们整个湖北省医疗物资情况。现在武汉市整个医疗系统及湖北省的整个医疗系统都已经越过了我们的省级、卫计委及各个行政部门、市政府、省政府，透过各大媒体。 在向社会发起物资募捐，这个物资是医疗物资，比如说我现在戴的护目镜、戴的一次性的口罩、戴的一次性的手套、身上穿的这个隔离衣、甚至是隔离裤，这个物资特别精确。我们现在的医护人员。 凡是从临床下来的，现在全部都又重新上了一线。我现在相当于就是在火线上给大家录这个录像，就是为了让大家引起警觉。我再强调一次，春节放假期间，不要出门，就自己在自己屋里待着，要不然我在前方拼命是为了什么？ 我就是为了让我的娃、我的亲人，他们健康。希望大家能够理解。我也知道，有些亲戚不在群里面，请看到我这个消息的人，相互打电话，相互通知，一定要做到。 我希望大家能够提高认识，这是一个政治任务，而且报告一个大家一个很不好的一个消息：这个新型冠状病毒已经发生第二代变异了，也就是说，在第一代变异的时候，我们可以对症治疗。 那么在发生第二代变异的时候，这是要命的。那它的感染几率就不是一个人传染，一个人得上的这种病传染身边14个人，那么它是呈爆发性质的。
And it's spreading rapidly. It's spreading rapidly. You see that? It's spreading rapidly. All right. Will spread so rapidly, and it is. It's already got out. It's already out of China. It's already in America. Or it's already worldwide, man. All right.
心智里，望大家一定要牢记，不要出门，不要串门，不要聚会，不要聚餐。谢谢大家。
There you have it. All right. Anyway, like I always say, we almost out of here, man. Keep pushing. Shalom. Wa Abad Babal.